We entered Serbia through the Croatian border.
Dobrodošli. So, we're just entering Serbia here. We couldn't cross border yesterday because all the system broke down. And for at least an hour we were waiting there. And it could be down for another 20 hours. So before it got dark, cycled a couple of kilometers back inland and camp. This morning we luckily crossed the border and we're gonna cycle in Serbia. Nothing else around but trees and jungle. Amazing.
And after cycling here for an entire hour, we left Serbia again and entered Hungary.
And entering Hungary. Welcome to Hungary.
I'm so happy. Köszönöm.
Magyarország. Yeah.
This is the Hungarian name in Hungary?
Yeah. Magyar.
Yeah, we need to learn some Hungarian.
This is the most exciting thing we have seen in Hungary so far. So it's this weirdly shaped tower.
And on the way to Budapest, we realized how much the scenery has changed.
This is our third day in Hungary, right?
Second day.
And look around. It's just flat and fields around and nothing.
It's really boring. There's nothing here. Sometimes you pass through villages and it's basically like a street with a few houses and like one little shop. And then there's like fields again. Now it's actually a bit better than it was. Now I think we're close to the Danube River and there are a few trees here on the left.
Showing the trees. Autumn kicked in and the leaves are getting golden, rusty. Hungary. Flatland paradise. Elena booked us warm showers for tonight and we have to cycle 100 kilometers in the rain. Maybe we have to 7 kilometers, 93 to go.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy, huh? And then it started to rain. And the road was very narrow and busy.
Okay, let's see the road first. Okay, that's the road we're cycling on. It's shit. Nothing around. We are hiding in the city hall. Here we are. In Hungary, 60 kilometers before Budapest. Look how much water is falling from the sky. Let's look at it. entering Budapest, and we have nice cycling path.
Let's see how Budapest is like.
After a long and rainy day, we finally arrived in Budapest.
After 100 kilometers cycling in the rain, in the
we witnessed an accident, and
yeah,
it was a crazy day.
He hit another car coming in front. Fortunately for him, it was just the mirror. Mirror exploded.
And, but the problem was that he didn't slow down. He passed us very fast. And
yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but we're in Budapest now.
So let's have a look.
Yeah.
Budapest.
This is
Budapest or Budapest. It's just like full of Austro-Hungarian architecture.
In the end, this terrible day ended well. We met our warm shower host and had a lovely evening. That's the view from our room.
How good is it that we are not camping tonight?
And what's the one thing you can't miss when you're in Budapest?
There's a queue in to buy a ticket for
Thermal bus.
Check this place out. That's a thermal bus.
The biggest in
Is this our walking tour?
Yes. It starts in front of the St. Stephen's Basilica.
It's massive, isn't it?
I heard it's the second highest building.
Massive thing.
just finished our city tour, which was very informative. We had food, we had some goulash and some mushroom stew with dumplings, very Hungarian food. And now we're walking to the parliament. Very exciting. What was your favorite fact of the tour, Arthur?
A parliament is built in the English style just to prove the independence from Austro Empire. So another fact about Budapest is that town used to be split in two. So what we're looking at now is Buda, which you can see it's very hilly. Pest side otherwise, it's completely flat.
This memorial honors the Jewish people who were killed during World War II. They were ordered to take off their shoes and shot at the edge of the water to fall into the river and be carried away.
Is it busy or not?
It's very busy. Everybody had the same idea we had.
You're queuing basically.
We are at the Great Market Hall now in Budapest. Unfortunately, it's raining a lot, so we had to use our ponchos again, like in San Francisco. And we just had cabbage rolls because we didn't have any breakfast, we're starving. And now we're gonna look for some food, and we're just looking at the souvenirs here. They're like typical, kind of communistic, Russian, Putin things, which is funny because we're in Budapest. But it's pretty here, it's a pretty hall, and it's dry.
And then we hit the road again.
This is how cycling Danube looks like. The route contains many cycle paths. Of course, some of them are along the river. River Danube or Dunau, whatever. Beautiful ride, however. You have to expect you will be cycling on the country roads, sharing the road with the cars. Sometimes they are fast, but it's alright. Nothing compared to cycling in South Hungary on road number 51 up to Budapest. That was a nightmare.
So, in the area in Hungary, in North Hungary, above Budapest, there are many wells like this, which is great. Don't really need to ask for water, but in the south we haven't seen them much.
Yeah,
huh?
There were
a few, but they didn't seem to really work. Here they are really good. Yeah. Fresh water.
Yeah, so we just press this thing here. With that, you press it, and there is water coming out. We arrived to Estergom, and we are about to cross the Hungarian-Slovak border. This is the border. The river is a border, actually. That's Dunaj. Here is Slovakia. Here we are in Hungary. It's quite nice town as well, where the walls a cathedral and some kind of castle. Beautiful Dunai. This is the bridge. This is Elena. Those are our bikes. There she is, cycling Danube in Slovakia. Now we are cycling Eurovelo 6, which is a nice ride. We have some pave, some gravel, some roads, some traffic, some quiet roads. It's alright.
Not getting boring.
No. Bratislava! On these pictures we can see castle on the hill and UFO bar. Hey, Tirol. Huh? We are having break in Czech Republic. maybe 50 kilometers before Ostrava. Our two last days of cycling. Here are our bikes. So I'm charging my phone over there. We didn't have any major issues with our bikes. So it was a great trip. What do you think, Elena?
Yeah, I'm a bit sad that it's
over.
Finishing.
Yeah.
Yeah, but at the same time it's getting really cold, so kind of happy to not camp soon anymore. We're putting everything on we own in the night, and it's not very comfortable to sleep this way. And my nose gets very cold, so.
Mm. We just stopped here and we refilled our bottles over there. I don't know if you can see. It was like a little tap. Nice. Okay. Bye-bye. Yeah. I just woke up in the freezing tent. We have only summer sleeping bags, but we layered crazy way. Some ice on the barriers. Bugs are sweating wet. No. Mental, very cold. But we slept a bit, you know. So it wasn't that bad. However, my feet are freezing cold.
One. Two. Three. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Is this our second last
night? Could be our last night too.
Yeah, maybe we'll spin it and get back home by the evening tomorrow.
Yeah, so we camp here in a beautiful forest.
Oh, it's beautiful. There is a little place for deers they can eat.
You should film this tree.
There is a bigger place for deers. This is the tree.
And we are camping under this beautiful branch.
And here's our tent. What a lovely home. Hmm? So here we are crossing the Polish border, Czech-Polish border, and we didn't expect doing it today, but we did it and we're gonna be home by tonight. We're very excited.
Nearly in Helembe.
This is probably one of our last videos. So this is Poland and we came from there. That's Czech Republic. Here is the border. That's how it looks like. There is a passport control guy.
A sock.
He's not moving, Mr. Sock. And there is a customs over there. Corns, they went through our bags looking for cigarettes, but we don't smoke because we cycle. Okay, bye.
Poland!
We're 36 kilometers away from home. And here we are on the hill, and we can see beautiful Silesian landscape. Here we are in Halemba, yeah.
We cycled from Bremen to Dubrovnik and back up to Poland. This is our last video of the series. We hope you enjoyed it. Give us a like and comment if you did, and check out the rest of the episodes. For more videos to come, subscribe to our channel. Next up is how we cycled in South Poland during the Corona summer. Bye!